Thank you. Now I'll be explaining this code. Basically, it's very simple, basic HTML, JavaScript over there. When we are calling this, when we are clicking this button, and then it is calling the function compared to with arguments as the values that the user entered, player one and player two entered. We are using DOM property, document.getElementById, and the ID is first value dot value property. And then likewise we are getting the second value, and we are just these are the arguments of this function compared to, because they are string, so we have to parse them to integers A and B for being able to apply this logic. So we are using this parsing method, and this is simple logic which is self-explanatory. Already video is long, so I'm not gonna elaborate it. In function compared, this is actually where we are playing with the system. So one value we are just giving it on our own. One is the random value which system is generating. Oh, hold on, I think I have made a mistake. It's not a mistake, it is unnecessary to use parseInt, because mat.floor will generate a number itself. Let me tell you. Just give me a second. Let's go. So here is it. This is our main thing. What the heck is this math.random? This will actually generate numbers in the range 0 to 3. This is closed, this is open. Sorry, 0 to 1. I beg pardon. When we are multiplying it by 3, we will be getting it in 0 to 3. These are floating point integers or floating point numbers, we can say. But we are concerned with 0, 1, and 2 values. We don't need that. So we are using mat.floor. So it will give us a set 0, 1, 2. Always we will be getting value of p from these three. This is the role of this mat.floor. Now why we need this parse in? ParseInt is basically when we are having a value like 123 in a string, and we are using ParseInt, and we are just getting this value as 123 integer type. So there is the use of ParseInt. So here we don't use ParseInt. Thanks a lot. Like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.